trying to fold the button allowance. Then once you have gotten to this stage, you open it up. Bear in mind that this stuff was 2 inches folding, right? Then you take the edge, put at the center fold, you fold this way, making it to be 1 inch now, right? This is how it should be. Then you fold again this way, right? Then you have reduced the 2 inches to 1 inch by the time you double fold it. This is how the folding is done, iron properly, right? Right guys, so now after folding, then you have to apply hemming gum. Bear in mind that this is the left part of the shirt, that's the button allowance part of the shirt, that's the one you use hemming gum. Now this hemming gum is going to give you a nice texture on the button allowance so that you have a nice feeling there. Then apply hemming gum beneath, and then you hem the first 1 inch fold as well. You also fold the next one, and then you also hem. You must put your hemming gum when you're doing this particular shirt material, because it's a shirt material. Except you're using a thicker one, you can now ignore hemming gum. Then you place the next one on top, that's the second folding, right? Then you fold this way, and then you turn it over this way, and then make sure the hemming gum is properly lapped. Don't allow your hemming gum to come out. Make sure the edge is properly inserted under of your outfit. Now, yeah, as you can see, I have finished hemming my button allowance. This is where, sorry, the buttonhole part, right? That the left panel of the shirt. This is the part you are going to hem. Then the other one will not be hemmed, but it will still be folded in this form. So, guys, now the next one, you have the next part of the shirt. Then you're not meant to hem, but you're going to double fold as well. The same way we did on the initial one, you double fold this way and then you iron. Make sure you iron properly, and then you have it in this form, right? That's the first folding. Then the next one will go in this direction. So that is how it's done. Then this is the first, the second shirt part. Then this one doesn't need to be added hemming gum because this is the one that will hold the buttons. Alright guys, so now I'm trying to fold the placket for the bigger one. Now in this shirt cutting, you don't necessarily need to gum, right? Because gumming will change the texture of this fabric. So I don't gum if I'm making a vintage shirt. The only thing I gum is the collar area. So the placket, don't forget the measurement was 2 inches by 6.5, right? Then you fold half an inch this way, and then, you fold the desired inch. Now, at the end of the day, you have something of this nature left. Make sure you leave this quarter inch here. This quarter inch will serve you to join this particular placket to the sleeve, right? So you go ahead and fold. You fold this on the both ends of the placket. That this is how it will be. Then you iron properly, right? Okay, so now